From The Selfish Path to Romance, download chapter 1 for free at drkenner.com.
My husband and I had an amazing experience in California, and it wasn't from lying out on the beach and relaxing, and we don't surf. We flew across the country so that he could have an operation. So listen to this. You might ask, you know, what's so exciting about that? Well, we take dance lessons. My husband skis, and he enjoys karate, or he has in the past, but his hips are giving out. They're aching much of the time. So he went for some routine scans, and a local doctor gave him some news. He said, "You got old man hips in a young man's body." Now, this is partly genetic, it's partly aging, you got the arthritis thing going on, and it's partly from wear and tear from years of martial arts. So my husband then faced a choice. He could either have two total hip replacements or just let his hips deteriorate. And he wouldn't be able to dance anymore, no more cha-chas, no more tangos, no more waltzes. But then to go into surgery, I mean, this is total hip replacement, both hips. For surgery, the stories we heard didn't make either of us want to rush to the phones because you'd have to put your life on hold for about 6 months. Now, of course, we're going to do it, but you don't look forward to doing this. And the operation itself sounded fairly gruesome. They have to cut through the large muscle groups in the back of your leg. Then they have to pop out the head of the femur. They have to cut the top of your big bone in the top of your leg, your femur. They have to wedge a ball with a spike into the cut leg. And then they have to clean out the hip socket and put a metal liner, glue a metal liner into it. And all the muscles and tendons and various other stuff would need to be cleaned out and sewn together. And then you have to stitch and staple the whole thing back together. So my husband would be spending weeks on crutches. He'd be taking pain medications. He'd had to have sleepless nights. And it would take him about up to 6 months for a full recovery to be back to normal, where he could at least try a cha-cha or a mambo again. And during the recovery time, he would not be able to cross his legs or bend them as we normally do, as we naturally do. And he'd only be able to sleep in a few positions. Now, my husband is active. He's energetic. He works out and he dances up to 4 hours a week. And I want to tell you, some weeks it's more than that. He skis. He takes long walks. So we're looking forward to at least a year, 6 months for one hip, 6 months to the other, of his being incapacitated. And last year he went through, I guess the last few years, he's gone through 2 rotator cuff surgeries, and he had had neck surgery a long time ago. So I'm thinking, oh no, not again.
This guy's a wreck.
I married a wreck. That's my husband. So, you know, I'm the living caretaker. So I'm mentally restructuring my immediate future. I'm preparing for months of caretaking, and I'm taking out the garbage, which is his job, cleaning the yard, helping him get his food, bathing him, chauffeuring him around. And then I spoke to my co-author. I have a book on romance, and my co-author said, "I had hip surgery last year, and my doctor is amazing." Now, you always hear stories about a doctor being amazing. And so we kind of blew it off because we have a very good doctor. And he says, "No, look at this brochure." And he brought us in a brochure of a new type of hip replacement. And he then said to me, "You know, I was playing tennis within 4 weeks of hip surgery, and I was playing competitive tennis within 6 weeks of my hip surgery." So at that point, he's got our attention. So my husband did a lot of research, and he went from the prospect of at least 6 weeks on crutches, 6 months to full recovery, down to, is it 3 months, 2 months? 3 weeks, 2 weeks, 1 week, would you believe days? So here's what we did. We flew out to Los Angeles, and my husband was operated on by Dr. Joel Matta, M-A-T-T-A, who, and you can reach him at hipandpelvis.com if anyone wants to research this themselves. He brought a new technique into this country. Instead of cutting through the back of the legs to reach the hip, you have to cut through all the large muscle groups. You do a lot of damage. Instead, he invented a new table, or he worked based on some information he got from France, from Paris, a doctor in Paris, invented a new table that allows him to twist your leg into a real weird position and not cut any muscles. You just move the muscles aside. Now, to my husband's credit, he did a lot of exercising beforehand to stretch his leg muscles so he could reduce the pain post-surgery. But my husband entered surgery. This is the day of surgery now, at 6 o'clock in the morning. 2 o'clock he was brought back up to his hospital room. The anesthesia wore off by five. The physical therapist came in and had my husband walking up four steps and walking up and down the halls of the corridor, the halls of the hospital, that same day, hours after surgery. Then, less than 24 hours after surgery, they had my husband walking with a cane, a full set of hospital stairs, and my husband decided that the cane was just a nuisance. He didn't need the cane. But they told him, use it anyway because it signals to other people that you just had surgery. The next day they discharged him with no limitations. 2 days after surgery, he was told that he could do anything he wanted to, provided it didn't hurt, and he can't get the scar wet. Now, the scar is glued together. He didn't even have stitches. It's glued together with human super glue, so it makes the recovery even easier. He has needed very few pain pills. 8 days after surgery, my husband took a full hour dance lesson, rumba and tango. And the dance instructor looked at him and said, I can't tell, which hip did you have done? And then the dance teacher says, I just saw it. It's your right hip, right? No, it wasn't. It was the left hip. So I cannot praise this surgeon enough. His name is Dr. Joel Matta, M-A-T-T-A. He's a top-notch surgeon, and he had been to France, as I said. He had seen the surgery done in a non-traditional way, and he told me privately that he had had so much experience in pelvic and hip surgery, and he was passionate about learning as much as he could, that when he saw this new procedure, he decided to introduce a similar one into the States. Now, it's new and radical, and that meant he's placing his excellent reputation at stake. Because if it doesn't work out, you know, you take a big risk like this and you can be condemned by your colleagues. His colleagues were not overly supportive of this new idea. But Dr. Joel Matta had confidence in his own mind, in his wealth of knowledge, in his skills, and in his years of experience. He invented a table that allows him to do this operation, and now he trains other surgeons around the country. Another surgeon from New Orleans was there while we were there, and he looked at my husband pre- and post-surgery and says, oh my God, my patients don't walk as well or feel as pain-free as you do until 6 months after surgery. This is 2 days after surgery. So a personal warm thanks and our tremendous admiration goes to you, Dr. Joel Matta. With your courage, your knowledge, your integrity, you saved my husband and all your other patients months of pain and months of recovery time. Thanks for being the type of person that both my husband and I can admire. And we'll be making another trip out to see you for the other hip. I'm Dr. Ellen Kenner. You're listening to The Rational Basis of Happiness, and I'll take your calls and questions coming up. But here's my number.
Here's an excerpt from The Selfish Path to Romance by psychologist Drs. Kenner and Locke.
A number of factors can cause the relationship to change, such as developing new ways of relating, handling conflict better, changing your perspective on your partner's attributes, or rethinking what you want. Even a great relationship can have some ups and downs. If the causes of the downs are resolved, then the upward trajectory can resume. Some rockiness may be caused by inner conflict over making a long-term commitment to someone rather than personality characteristics of the partner. The process of meshing together the many aspects of your life with those of another unique individual is not easy, but so long as communication remains strong, honest, tactful, and respectful, partners can often resolve such problems and strengthen their love.
You can download Chapter 1 for free at drkenner.com, and you can buy the book at amazon.com.